Dear student, today's topic is nano imprinting lithography. Today we are going to learn about nano imprinting lithography. The nano imprinting lithography includes various contents like introduction of nano imprint lithography, working principle of nano imprint lithography, nano imprinting lithography techniques, advantages and applications. The first one content is the basic introduction of nano imprinting lithography. This nano imprinting lithography is a non-conventional lithography method which is used for fabricating nanoscale patterns. It was invented in 1995. It is a simple process with low cost, high throughput and high resolution, lower than 10 nanometer. It is considered as the most promising nanolithography technique for other applications like integrated circuits. It offers the simple approach of physically pressing patterns on a mask onto the resin. This approach also produces extremely sharp circuit patterns. It is expected to contribute to lower chip defect rates. So here the basic working principle of nano imprint lithography. This nano imprint lithography creates a patterns by mechanical deformation of imprint resist and subsequent processes. The imprint resist is typically a monomer or polymer formulation that is cured by heat or ultraviolet light during the imprinting. Adhesion between the resist and the template is controlled to allow proper release. This technology basically having two steps. The first one is imprint step and the second one is the pattern transfer step. In the imprint step, it is a mold with nanostructure on its surface is pressed into a thin resist cast on a substrate, which is followed by removal of the mold. This step duplicates the nanostructures on the mold in the resist film. The pattern transfer step. In this step, an anisotropic etching process, that is also called as a reactive ion etching, is used to remove the residual resist in the compressed area. This step transfers the thickness contrast pattern into the entire resist. During the imprint step, the resist is heated to a temperature above its glass transition temperature. At this temperature, the resist, which is thermoplastic, becomes a viscous liquid and can flow and therefore can be readily deformed into a shape of the mold. The resist viscosity decreases as the temperature increases. So here this is the basic structure of nano imprint lithography process. This is the stamp. This is also called mold, and this is uses the silicon quartz material, etc. So this mold is basically pressed into a substrate, that is first this mold is pressed into the thin resist cast on a substrate. Now the imprint resist is heated to a temperature above its glass transition temperature. At that temperature, the resist becomes a viscous liquid, can be readily deformed into the shape of the mold. The reactive ion etching is used here to remove residual resist in the compressed area. So this is the basic process of nano imprinting lithography. Here the nano imprinting lithography techniques are used. There are basically two important techniques. These are the thermal nano imprint lithography and ultraviolet nano imprint lithography, and the third one is replication molding. This first step, this is the thermal nano imprinting lithography. This is a technique which is a thermoplastic polymer is embossed by the master above the polymer's glass transition temperature. allowing the molten polymer to flow and fill the mold pattern. The applied pressure is maintained during cooling to below the glass transition temperature, thus producing a solid replica. The second one technique is ultraviolet nanolithography. This technique uses ultraviolet curable resist, which allow for room temperature processing in application where the underlying substrate is sensitive to imposing temperatures. Imprint pressure by using liquid resist formulation that have low viscosity and low surface energy before crossing can also be significantly lowered or even reduced to zero. In ultraviolet nanoimprint lithography, the molds are typically transparent to ultraviolet and visible light, enabling alignment of mold pattern to existing substrate feature because the entire substrate mold sandwich is not heated as a unit. Ultraviolet nanoimprint lithography is amenable to stab and flash where a small die is imprinted in series across a large wafer. Here, this is the basic structure of the nanoimprint lithography techniques. The first one is based on thermal nanoimprint lithography. The second one is based on ultraviolet nanoimprint lithography. And the third one is based on replication molding. So, here, these are the advantages and applications of nanoimprinting lithography. These are the advantages. The nanoimprint lithography having cost efficient, high resolution and high throughput, simple technology and flexible. The applications are, it can be used to make optical, photonics, electrical and biological devices. And advances in mold manufacturing will have wide application of nanoimprint lithography in smaller devices. It is capable of replicating features below 10 nanometer over large area substrate. Is a technology to allow nanostructure manufacturing for advancing ICs. These are the some enabling technologies that is associated with the nanoimprint lithography process. These are included MEMS and NAMS, displays, data storage, biotech, pharmaceuticals, semiconductor integrated ICs, and etching, etc. The wireless communication. These are the some nanoimprint enables multiple techniques that is used in industries also. Thank you for watching.